But we moved here 25 years ago. What I think you guys say, we got here as quickly as we could, and that is 25 years ago. 25 years ago, we moved here because of the opportunities that this country has to offer. We started our own business, which we still run and operate, and we are now moved permanently to Bandera County, and we live on Medina Lake. And we are very passionate about Medina Lake. And I really think all of us has to appreciate this is what you see in a great democracy. This is what it's all about, is people showing up for their passions and showing what they believe and expressing. This is working fully under the Constitution. We were here about a month ago on the last board meeting of BMA and made a presentation where we asked the board please to take action to put meters on the gates at Medina Lake. During that discussion, one of the board members came with the following remark, and I quote, and this is an accurate quote, and it is not taken out of context. Here we go. Why don't you come and try to buy water, and we leave it behind the dam? Let me repeat that again. Why don't you, which was us, come and try to buy water, and we leave it behind the dam? In my opinion, the only reasonable interpretation of this statement is that it is within BMA's powers to leave more water in Medina Lake than what they do. However, as long as we give them money, this is within their powers. Except for the money part, this is exactly what we've been claiming all the way along. Proper management of the valves in Medina Lake will ensure that more water is left in Medina Lake, which is to the benefit of the irrigation users, because this is ultimately their bank for water. And for the all the environment around the local community and all the users of the lake. So we are, except for the money piece, we are on the same page. And what we're urging you to use your power that you now clearly have said you have to manage these gates properly so there are more water left in this lake. BMA is a political subdivision of the state of Texas, and they have a clear responsibility to manage water properly without asking to be bribed by the citizens of this state.
Mr. Perez, the speaker has spoken for 3 minutes, according with our time, that's the time limit for each speaker.
Can we get the next speaker, Rachel Mueller, is that right?
Mulheron. You're not the only one that's mispronounced. Good evening, my name is Rachel Mulheron, and I'm too a member of the Save Medina Lake Committee, which is part of the Lake Medina Conservation Society, a 501(c) nonprofit. Since the BMA does not keep records on when and how much the Medina Lake Dam valves are opened and closed, the Save Medina Lake has been closely monitoring and charting the valve status and its effect on Medina Lake. And I'm here today to share the information with the board and those attending this meeting what we have discovered. The 36-inch valve on Medina Lake Dam has remained open since June 10th of this year, with the exception of 1 week in July. Based on the valve manufacturer specifications, and you'll see those in the handout, our committee has calculated that greater than 29,000 acre-feet has been released from Medina Lake, and of that, 20,000 acre-feet has flowed through the canal system during this period, which is greater than the 12,000 and 7,400 that has been approved in the June and August board meetings. Unlike other lakes, such as the Lower Colorado River Authority, San Jacinto River Authority, Trinity River Authority, and other lakes, the Medina Lake Dam does not have flow meters on the valves. So no one knows exactly how much water is discharged from the lake, ever. Despite this, we believe our calculations are very conservative, so it is not understood why one valve on the dam and the 5 gates on the canal system remain open. This water that is now being released should be conserved in Medina Lake so that it is available when the farmers need it most should our region go back into another drought cycle. When the farmers have water, we at the communities at the lake have water. And that includes San Antonio. This is the lake that San Antonio goes to. In 2010, if the strategy of opening and closing the valves to only release the permitted water that had been used, then Medina Lake would have been 100% full versus 66, and would have been in better position to provide essential water during the drought period. Instead, one or both valves were left open on Medina Lake until April 2013, needlessly draining the lake to 6%. And as a result, the farmers and the communities around the lake went without for 3 years without water, devastating both. So we implore the board tonight to shut the valve, conserve the water in Medina Lake until it's most needed. This is the right thing to do. It makes sense and it's good for everyone. And just for the record here for the board, I do not claim to be a professional engineer nor geoscientist. I'm an IT professional. Thank you for your time.
Can we get the next speaker, please? I might say this wrong, Rochelle.
Rochelle.
Okay.
My name is Michelle Reich. I'm also part of the Save Medina Lake group. Thank you for listening to us today. I find it troubling that the BMA, a political subdivision of the state of Texas, seems to be trying to aggressively silence citizens that may question water management policy. All of the water in the Medina Lake is owned by the people of the state of Texas, and the rights to the water that the BMA have are given to them by the people of the state of Texas. Blaming all the problems on a drought and then not wanting to hear or discuss other obvious solutions is not what we expect from our government agencies. Even worse, the clear attempt to silence the citizens from voicing opinion is a violation of our constitutional rights. The Save Medina Lake Committee has done extensive research on the Medina Lake system, and we want to help find solutions to better management policy that will keep the farmers and local community from losing their water again. Yet the BMA has instructed us that they will no longer take phone calls from our committee members. This is not how government is supposed to function. We would like to take the opportunity to invite the BMA board members to come up to Medina Lake, sit down with us, and discuss the challenges that we're all facing in managing this resource to the benefit of everyone involved. We look forward to hearing from you.
Next one is Jody Daniels.
Thank you. In June of this year, the BMA filed a complaint against Mike Crandall with the Texas Board of Professional Geoscientists. The BMA asserted in this complaint Mr. Crandall was affecting the public's health, safety, and welfare and illegally practicing geoscience. The BMA complaint was the result of Mike Crandall posting the Medina Lake hydrology page on the internet. This page was read by thousands of people in the area, and it was a valuable tool in helping the public learn how the Medina Lake system works for the farmers. As a result of the BMA complaint, Mr. Crandall took this educational tool based on decades of professional research by the United States Geological Service off the internet. We've had a number of farmers on our Facebook page since ask, why doesn't Save Medina Lake try to educate the public? We were thwarted in that area. In the complaint, the BMA states the following, and I quote, "The excerpt from a previous study presented on page 43 has implied authorship by BNC Engineering, which per a search does not appear to be a firm currently licensed to perform engineering in the state of Texas. Again, the use of a citation to an engineer in the study implies technical validity of the conclusions presented," unquote. So the BMA, accompanied by their attorney and two hired engineers, is forcing the local water ski coach into a hearing in Austin to try to prove his educational effort is breaking Texas law by using data from an engineering company the BMA says isn't licensed in Texas as far as they can find looking all over the internet. Yet BNC Engineering helped prepare a 200-page regional water management plan for the BMA in 1999. The Medina County Regional Water Management Plan, prepared by Bear Medina Atascosa, WCID number 1, in association with BNC Engineering.
Needless to say, the Texas Board of Professional Geoscientists found in the hearing this past Friday that none of the complaints by the BMA against Mike Crandall were credible at all. The finding cleared Mr. Crandall of any wrongdoing. Why does the BMA, a government entity, feel it needs to go after the local water ski coach? Aren't there better ways for the BMA to use their time and money to ensure the farmers don't lose their water again? Thank you.
David Cruz.
Mr. President Pro Tem, members of this board, and distinguished guests, I normally don't speak. I stand behind the camera, but since I was not afforded the opportunity to have introduced myself properly to Mr. Berger, who is the hired general manager of this operation. In fact, the 27-second phone call that I had with him went like this, and I think you as board members need to know. I'm going to Google you to see who you are. Oh, and until I know what your views are, I'll decide when I'm going to talk to you. Click, the phone went dead. 27 seconds. So let me tell you who I am. I'm a 43-year broadcast journalist that has worked for every major network in America. I own property on Medina Lake, and my family has for more than half a century. We're stakeholders here, and I'm now the owner, publisher, and general manager of this station, the station that's going to be broadcasting each of your meetings. Now, we come here to learn and to participate with you. But if this antagonism that I have considered very, very unfriendly has occurred to me, what is it doing to the people of this community? We're all in this together. You don't even have a website. I don't think any of us came here in a horse and buggy. I know I didn't. And all of us have cell phones. That's called technology. Here's what I've learned over 43 years of covering public agencies. Where there is no public oversight, people do what they want to do. That's going to change. Our camera will be here at every legally and duly noticed meeting, and it was hard to find where you post your notices, but we will stay on the ball and we will be back. And if you continue to harass me when I am here as a member of the media and we're credentialed, you're not a credentialing agency. You cannot block media from being here. And for you to interfere with my activity today is inappropriate and unprofessional. But we're going to stay here. We will broadcast every minute that you're doing these meetings, and I hope that we can have a working relationship, because there's only two ways to do it, the right way or the hard way. Thank you very much.
We will now move to